In this video, we established that any vector can be written as a sum of vector components, and we learned to convert between the component form of a vector and the polar form of a vector. On this slide, we have a picture of some arbitrary vector v, and I've also included some dashed horizontal and vertical lines for reference. Note that the angle of the vector is labeled with respect to the x-axis here as theta. Now, the idea of vector components is that we realize the same vector v could be written as the sum of two other vectors. In this case, we could do it with a horizontal vector added to a vertical vector. And what I mean by vector added is that we add them head to tail. If the tail of the second vector is stuck to the head of the first, and we draw a vector from the tail of the first to the head of the second, that's vector addition. Now, because these are horizontal and vertical, we would ordinarily call this horizontal component vx. That's the x component of the vector v. And the vertical component, of course, we would call vy. And we can say that our original vector v is the vector sum of vx added to vy. So in practice, we'll be finding the magnitudes of these things by using right triangle trigonometry. As long as you have the hypotenuse and the angle there, you can find the size of the legs. And before we move on, I want to point out that vector components don't have to be horizontal and vertical, but they're almost always perpendicular to each other. And one final stylistic note here is that typically we'll show that y component attached to the tail of the original vector. Remember that vectors are totally movable. They have length and direction, but they don't have absolute position. So we can just move that vertical component, vy, and attach it to the tail of the original vector. So we'll wrap things up by computing a couple sets of vector components. In the first example, we want to compute the x and y components of a vector v. And in the second example, we compute components for the exact same vector, but we use a tilted coordinate system, which changes the size of the components. So in our first example, we're told the vector v is given in polar form below. Compute the magnitudes of the x and y components. So we'll just drop a vertical line right here to form a right triangle. And my x component looks like this, and my y component looks like this. And then to find the magnitudes of these things, we have to use right triangle trigonometry. And we know the cosine of 60 degrees is going to be the adjacent side of this triangle divided by the hypotenuse. And we can quickly solve for that adjacent side. It's 5 times cosine of 60 degrees. And we get an answer of 2.5 for the magnitude. We apply the sine function to deal with the vertical component. The sine of 60 is the opposite over the hypotenuse. We multiply by the hypotenuse, and we get Vy is 5 sine of 60 degrees. And to 3 sig figs, we find that has a magnitude of 4.33. Now, before we move on, I want to point out that that x component was found from taking the hypotenuse multiplied by the cosine, and the y component was found by multiplying the hypotenuse times the sine. And it's very common in physics to just jump straight to this answer instead of going all the way back to the cosine being the adjacent over the hypotenuse, and similar for the sine function. So we're typically going to streamline in that way, and I'll illustrate that in the second example. In the second example, we have the exact same vector, but I have a tilted coordinate system that I called the x prime, y prime coordinate system. And this kind of tilted vector decomposition is actually really typical in a physics course, especially when we're dealing with inclined plane problems. So one way to say what we're doing here is we want to project our original vector onto these tilted axes. So I'm going to drop a line that looks like this, perpendicular to the x prime axis. Now I can view my original vector v as a vector sum, again, just head to tail vector addition, of a vector that's parallel to the x prime axis and a vector that's parallel to the y prime axis. And I can call the lengths of these things vx prime and vy prime. One thing I have to do before I start actually writing down any math is I have to figure out what's that angle right there. And the angle between the original yellow vector and the horizontal was 60 degrees. Well, this is going to be 20 degrees less than that, so that's 40 degrees. And now we can get Vx prime in one step. I take the hypotenuse multiplied by the cosine of the angle, cosine of 40, and that gives me that adjacent side. And this gives me a magnitude of 3.83. We do a similar thing for the y component, and I get Vy prime is 5 sine of 40 degrees, and this gives me a magnitude of 3.21. So to summarize what happened here, there are infinitely many ways of decomposing a vector into two perpendicular components, just depending on what angle you're interested in for your coordinate system. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.